damage to the rear wing, you have damage to your rear.
Ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid.
Hamilton, Bottas,
and Max Verstappen. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix.
Who would you say is your biggest rival at the moment? How does the poor weather change your strategy going into the race? Are you happy with where you'll be on the grid tomorrow? How do you feel about this team's performance this season? Great! Well, that's everything.
Here we are again then at Le Castellet for another round of this year's Formula One World Championship. Renault took their first French Grand Prix win all the way back in the inaugural race in 1906, but it was another 73 years before they could take their second. I'm sure Alpine will be pushing hard to delight the local fans here today. Mastering a lap of Paul Ricard means getting to know 15 corners, 6 left and 9 right, for an overall lap distance of 3.6 miles. The two halves of the long Mistral Strait are separated by a heavy braking zone into a potential overtaking hotspot at the chicane Nord. And watch out for the drivers running onto the distinctive coloured stripes, which are low in grip and highly abrasive. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about more. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
They've been avoiding mistakes and have had solid pace, so it's been a good season so far, but whether they can keep that up long term remains to be seen.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Leclerc, Lando Norris, and Perez, Sainz, Gasly, Moore, and Daniel Ricciardo, Vettel, Ocon, Lance Stroll, and Mick Schumacher, Giovinazzi, Mazepin, Nicholas Latifi, and George Russell. They've taken a grid penalty. Raikkonen and Yuki Tsunoda. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track and get this Grand Prix underway.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. tight race over, take care of the car on the way in.
The Mercedes team pulled out a fantastic performance today. They should be proud. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection, a shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. Lewis Hamilton takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after an excellent result. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Anthony Davidson, who do you pick?
Kimi Raikkonen is my standout today. Nothing you could construe as showboating, just an incredibly consistent performance out on track.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
Out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. You're no longer in the top spot. Are you hoping to regain it? It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? Do you feel that your teammate put on a good show for the home crowd? Great. Well, that's everything.
Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.